in this particular video, I am actually trying to present you the three main systems which actually need to be considered whenever you are actually doing a agile transformation. Okay, so the first thing is actually called as the system of a delivery, and then the system of a transformation, followed by the system of a continuous improvement. So whenever we are actually embarking on an agile transformation journey, any kind of an activity what we actually do within this particular transformation journey can be compartmentalized into these three main pillars. One is called the system of a delivery, second is the system of a transformation, and the third thing is actually called as the system of a continuous improvement. Okay, now when it comes to the system of a delivery, what it means is that we are going to focus on the product road mapping and followed by the project release planning, whatever you actually do as a BAU, day-to-day basis, in terms of your Scrum, your Kanban, your Squad, or your Spotify, or your Safe framework, whatever you are actually doing on a day-to-day basis so as to execute your product roadmap or your project release planning. These particular set of activities will actually come under system of a delivery. When it comes to system of a transformation, it is actually creating an agile transformation roadmap. Okay, let's say for example, creating an outcome based plan to do an agile transformation roadmap followed by the coaching plan. For example, agile coaches need to create a coaching plan, right, so as to coach the team or the team of teams. So all these particular activities come under a system of a transformation. And then followed by the third thing is called as the system of a continuous improvement. So in this particular continuous improvement, we are going to focus on creating a Kaizen roadmap, okay, and then trying to execute this particular Kaizen roadmap also as a part of the journey. Okay, now, okay, so before I get into the crux of this particular video, just to introduce myself, my name is Balaji. I am currently playing the role of an executive agile coach, taking care of a digital transformation initiatives and business agility related initiatives for multiple clients. Okay, so when we actually deep dive into this particular system of a delivery, we actually need to focus on the product roadmap followed by the project release planning, and predominantly how does my Scrum or Kanban or the DevOps teams are executing their own way of projects or products, right? And when you come to the system of a transformation, the first and foremost is let us be clear on the business objectives or the business drivers behind this particular transformation journey. And then in the particular system of a transformation, I also used to focus on the organization change management model. Okay, the point is, whenever we are actually embarking on a large scale transformation which is actually going to have a significant impact, it is always better to focus on the organization change management model as a part of the continuous activity. Now I have something called as an in my particular transformation roadmap, we actually create an outcome based plan and also create some kind of a tagging it back to the timelines. Okay, what are all the particular outcomes which need to be achieved within which particular timelines? But the point is, this particular system of transformation can be evaluated only on the system of a delivery. Okay, say for example, a particular agile coach had actually given coaching on how to put a WIP limit, work in progress limit, on the portfolio Kanban board. Okay, now if you take at a user story level, it will be like, you know, requirement analysis, design, development, testing done. If you take at a feature and a sub-epic level, discovery, define, design, implementation, done, deployment. So an agile coach would have coached the team how to put a WIP limit, what are all the pros and cons of it, and if you actually don't put a WIP limit, how are you actually building a queue in the system which is going to curtail the flow of agility. Now, where will I go and test the validity of this particular coaching effectiveness? Once again, I need to come to the system of delivery to check how far the effectiveness or the efficiency of the coaching has been imparted to the teams. Now the third thing is called as a system of a continuous improvement. So in this particular journey of a continuous improvement, it could be from the team level retrospective or the program increment level retrospective or from the go live or the production deployment, the post go live retrospective or from the agile assessment, know the outcomes of the agile maturity assessment, or it could be from the waste identification workshop. So based on n number of sources, we actually create the inputs to my case and backlog. Okay. Now the point what I'm trying to tell is, how do you really balance all these things? Okay, because you need to balance all these things, right? So these three main pillars can be balanced and harmoniously executed, provided you are actually taking care of five main things. One is the product roadmap. Second is the agile release planning. Okay, the project planning. The third thing is the agile transformation roadmap. Fourth thing is the coaching plan created by the coach. And the fifth thing is the Kaizen or the continuous improvement roadmap. So one of the concepts, if I want to give a quick analogy, in the branch of Ayurveda, it has been told that any kind of a dosha or any kind of a disease a person gets, it is predominantly due to the imbalance of vata, pitta, followed by the kapha, right? Vata, pitta, and the kapha. So if I actually want to give a kind of an analogy, the fire element, the water element, the earth element, followed by the air element, and then followed by the akasha or the space, which we call it as a ether. So all these five things need to be balanced in a human body. So any kind of a dysfunction, any kind of a disease, as far as the Ayurveda science is been considered, predominantly tells that because of the imbalance of these five main things. From my perspective, I just wanted you to tell, if you want to harmoniously execute your agile transformation from your end to end, from my perspective, what I say is, try to balance all these five things. One is the product roadmap initiative or the priorities. Second is the project planning or the agile release planning. It could be for a major release or a minor release. Followed by the third thing is the transformation roadmap, wherein my agile transformation and outcome based plan is being captured. And the fourth thing is the coaching plan created by the coaches, and followed by the fifth thing is the Kaizen roadmap or the continuous initiative. Okay, so let me take a pause here. If in case you have any queries or challenges, or if you want to connect with me to actually deep dive on this particular topic, I will be sharing my WhatsApp number in the description of the video. Okay, cheers all, bye.